गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ HTML. स्टूडेंट्स, टिल नाउ वी हैव डन डिफरेंट एट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ द टेबल लाइक टेबल बॉर्डर, सेल स्पेसिंग, सेल पैडिंग, बॉर्डर विथ, बॉर्डर हाइट, अलाइन, वी अलाइन, कोल स्पैन एंड रो स्पैन. In today's class, we will cover page number 37 and 38 half, and we will discuss introduction to DHTML. We will discuss different components of the DHTML like HTML, cascading style sheet, document object model. So, students, open your books at the page number 37. Students, today we are going to start introduction to DHTML. Before starting it, I want to make you clear that DHTML is not a particular language. It is an art of making dynamic and interactive web pages. Students, there is a word dynamic. Dynamic means changeable. Changeable means the working is done on the web pages when it execute. Means the colors of the buttons will change when we click on it. Picture will zoom in, zoom out like that. Means animation effects we can make with DHTML. And its full form is dynamic hypertext markup language, and it is used to create animations, games and applications. It makes the web experience faster and more interactive for the user end. It makes our web page more interactive as compared to the HTML. So students, let us discuss the difference between HTML and DHTML. How the DHTML is more interactive and useful as compared to HTML. Students, HTML's full form is hypertext markup language, and DHTML's full form is dynamic hypertext markup language. Students, as we have completed the codings of HTML, you know that HTML creates static web pages. Word static is there. Static means still. Means whatever the font color, background color, picture height, width, table, border, etc. Whatever the coding is done before executing the web page, that result only will be shown on the output window. No other animations or color changing can be done on the execution time, but this is possible with the help of DHTML. DHTML creates dynamic web pages. We can do animations, we can change the colors of the buttons on click, on mouse over, or by taking the mouse out from it like that. HTML creates simple plain pages without styles and script. Means the styles and scripting language is not used in HTML. But DHTML creates a page with HTML, CSS, DOM and JavaScript. Students, note that DHTML is a combination of HTML, JavaScript, DOM and CSS, and we are going to discuss all these combinations in detail. Students, different components of DHTML are HTML, cascading style sheet and document object model. Students, in the last classes we have done detailed discussion about HTML, and its full form is hypertext markup language. And HTML is a language used to create or design web page. It defines the structure of web page using different basic elements like headings, forms, tables, and links, etc. Second component we are having, that is CSS. Now the new concept is coming with the CSS, and its full form is cascading style sheet. What is cascading style sheet? CSS is a simple mechanism for adding styles, means different types of styles can be added to our web page with the help of this CSS, like font, color to the web documents. Different types of styles, different types of dynamic styles we can add with the help of this CSS. Now the next component we are having, DOM. The full form of DOM is document object model, and all the components of DHTML like JavaScript, CSS and HTML, all components are linked with the help of this DOM, means document object model. What is DOM? DOM is an interface that allows scripting language to assess the contents, styles and structure of web page and change them dynamically. So, DOM defines the objects and properties of all HTML elements and the methods to assess them. Now, to do the practical, we are going to start with the DHTML event handler. Now, the students, there is a word that is event. Event means any action or work to be done. Means that when I click on the mouse, that is an event. When I'm moving the mouse left to right, that is also event. The color is changing on clicking, that is an event. These types of events. And event handler allow you to execute code when an event occurs. And different types of event handlers are as follows. First is mouse over, means when my mouse is coming over a particular text, particular event will happen. Maybe the color changing, maybe the font increasing, like that. Second is mouse out, means when my mouse is out from the text, that is also event. Third is on mouse move, means when my mouse is moving on the particular text. And last event we are having on click. On click means on a particular text when my mouse will click. Now we are going to do these four event handler practically. For that we will open our web page in the notepad. And students, first of all I want to increase the font size. Font size is equal to 6, so that my text will be more visible to you people. Now let's suppose I want the h1. H1 means the heading 1, and I want to write mouse over, on mouse over. On mouse over is equal to this dot style dot color, means on mouse over is an event. And this is the keyword, means when my mouse is over on the particular text, style, the style will change. Which type of style? Color. I have given color is equal to red, whatever the color I want to give. Now I will write my text click here, I have written the text. I will close this H1. Now students, note that I have given H1 and I have given the event on mouse over, means when my mouse is coming over the text, that is click here, and this means this event will happen. Then style, which style? Color style will change to red, and I have written text, click here. I'll save my work. I will close it and see the output. By default, my color of the text is black. When my mouse pointer, this is my mouse pointer, when it is going over the text, the color is changed to red. That is a dynamic. This work is not done with the help of HTML. On the execution time, we can make our web page more interactive with the help of DHTML. Now students, we are going to do the second event handler, that is mouse out. Mouse out means when I do the coding, I am going to change the coding. Mouse over, I will write mouse out, and color will be green. Only I will change the event name and the color so that it will make you more clear. Now I have used the event, that is on mouse out, means when my mouse will out from the text, then the style color will change to green. Now I will save my work and see. I will double click on it. By default, color is black. When my mouse is going over here, now no color is changing. When mouse is coming out from there, the color changed to green. So this event is mouse out. Now next event we are going to do, that is mouse on mouse move. On the place of on mouse out, I will write mouse move, and I will write over there blue. Earlier I have written blue, green, now I am writing blue. Now next event handler I have used, that is on mouse move, means when my mouse will move on the text, the color of the text will change to blue. I will save my work. I'll close it. Now see the result. Now students, when my mouse will move over the text, I have not clicked, I only move the mouse, the color changes to blue. And last event handler we are going to do, that is on click. For that we will write on click. On click, and I will write the color red. I'll save my work. I'll close it and I will open my text. Now see, when my mouse is coming or going out, the color is not changing, but when I click on the text, the color is changed to red. These four event handlers will work separately also and collectively also. Now we will do all these handlers together with the different colors. So for that we will open our text, and I will copy this coding. I will copy on click coding and paste over here, and I will change its mouse event to the on mouse over, and I will change the color to blue. Third event handler we have done, again I will paste the text, and on mouse out, on mouse out, and I will change the color to yellow. Any one or all three we can use. I'll paste the text again, and what I will do, on mouse move and color to green. Any one we can use or all four we can use. I have given first event handler on click. On clicking it will turn to red. On mouse over it will turn to blue. On mouse out it will turn to yellow. And on mouse move it turned to green. And I'll save my work and close it. Now see the output screen. By default text color is coming to the black. When my mouse is going over it, it changes to green. When I click on it, it changes to red. And when my mouse is coming out, it turns to yellow. So students, in this lecture we have done different types of event handlers in DHTML, and we have done the difference between HTML and DHTML and the different components of the DHTML. Do the practical of the event handlers with the help of school links and do the project works at your home. Thank you so much.